Hey everybody, it's Billy from Spicy Ginger Soap, and I got a comment. I can't remember who it's from, and I haven't even messaged her back yet, but I got a comment that I saw last night, and it asked me something about, I noticed that you don't use the Press It binder mix. I'm having issues with my eyeshadows crumbling. It was something to that effect, right? So I told you guys I don't wear eyeshadow normally. So I was like making all these beautiful eyeshadows. I hadn't used any of them yet. So I saw that comment and I went to my palette and I decided to use every single one of them. Now, right off the bat, I noticed that this one right here, let me get my little orangewood stick, this one right here, which is, I believe, the antique copper, I think, I'm not positive, but this one right here, you can see how it's like got some like, it was lifting kind of, and then my gold, the same thing. It's almost like I had a little bubble underneath it. Is that gonna focus? There we go. It's like I had a little bubble there underneath the first layer, and I thought, well, did I not press them good enough? Not really sure, because a lot of the other ones, like this one right here, this triple X, smoky triple X, that's that one. That one is good. This one's good. This one's good. This one's good. Even my Black Star Blue, most of those look okay. When I put my brush to them, they did seem to be a little bit more powdery, crumbly than they should be or that I would prefer them to be. So it seems like the more glitter that's in them, these that are highly glittered, they seem to be the most powdery. I don't know if that is what the issue is or if it's an issue with the formulation. I've seen many people make the eyeshadows exactly the same way that I did, and that's how they instruct to make them. But that being said, I mean, I'm learning this. You know, this is the first time I had ever made them, so obviously there's trial and error. There's a learning curve. I don't profess to know everything about making eyeshadows, pressing eyeshadows, whatever. So I'm learning along with everyone. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and depot some of these and I'm going to redo them. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do them with a base. So an eyeshadow base that I have both a pre-mixed one from TKB, and then I also am going to go ahead and make one. So we're going to go ahead and do it together, and hopefully this will address the question that I was asked, and maybe some other people are having issues of the same as well. So I'm going to get everything ready and then I'll come back. Okay, everybody, this is what we're going to do. I've chosen the ones that I feel are the most powdery and dusty. And we're gonna do a couple different things. I've got the My Mix press base. And then I've got two different recipes. I have this one, and it is basically like two parts talc, one part zinc oxide, two parts bismuth, oxychloride, and then to that it's like 12 parts color. So I'll use like, basically I'm going to use this whole amount for these two. So hopefully that'll work out well. And then I've got another one that I'm going to use for this one right here, my white gold, And that one is basically like 5 parts talc, 1 part bismuth, 1 part boron nitride. Or you could use kaolin clay. I didn't want kaolin clay because I have dry skin. And then you would add like 2 parts color, 1 to 2 parts color. So I'll use, I will be using about 1/2 container. So basically I've got a few different recipes and we're kind of going to do a little experiment on what works the best. That's what I figured out to do. So the way that I'm going to do this is I'm going to put my eyeshadow in the pan and then I'm just going to basically I'm going to break it up. Once I've got all of it out, I'm going to kind of like crush it up a little bit. Get the rest of what's in this little pan. And then I'm going to get my, remember this one is talc, bismuth, oxychloride, and boron nitride. So that's what base I'm using for my white gold. And I'm going to use my trusty little spoon set here. And I'm just going to spoon it in here. You know, I hope no one's upset about if they did any of these and had trouble with them because, you know, I am just learning just like everybody else as far as the makeup goes. You know, you guys could ask me any question you want about soap and I'm not going to know every single one, but probably I'm going to know almost all of the questions you might have about soap. I can answer those with a fair bit of confidence and whatnot, but as far as making eyeshadows go and making makeup, that's, you know, it's something that's new for me. So I'm going to go ahead and actually close this up, this little baggie here, and I'm just going to kind of like flick it around a little. And I'm using my fingers to press it together. And yeah, it kind of loses. I'm going to put some more of the actual mica in there because that's going to make it too light, I think. It basically takes away the concentration of that nice shimmer that I had going on. So I don't want to lose that. That's the whole reason I like that color. So I'm going to get my gold sparks out. Ooh, wow. Every time I open this one, it really flies all over the place. And I'm going to put some more of it in there. And basically what's probably going to be happening is I'm going to have basically like two pans of this because I've got all the extra product in there. All right, so I added more. And again, I'm just going to mix it on up. And there we go. We have it in the baggie, all nice and mixed up. And now what we'll do is we'll get our pan, and I'm not going to worry about the little bits that are in there right now. I just don't think that's that big of a deal. I'm going to put two drops of the Press-It binder. And then I'm going to get a little bit of alcohol. That was kind of a lot, but that's okay. And just mix everything together. And then we're going to do the same thing we did before. And we're going to see how this goes. And what I've planned to do is, once I do these with you all, then I'll bring you back tomorrow. And I will show you how they're looking. You know, basically if it was, maybe I'll wait a couple of days to make sure that it was successful. All right, there we go. And I hope, I tried to change the angle of the camera, and I'm hoping you can see a little bit better. I made it closer. You know, it's, the makeup videos are a lot different than the soap videos for me. Still kind of trying to figure out the best way to do them. So that is looking pretty good. I would say it's pretty nice and mixed. There we go. This is actually, this would make making these cheaper also, because you're using less of the actual mica, which would be the most expensive part. And let me just tell you guys, So last night after I saw that comment, I went and I put every single one of these on. I tested all of them out on myself. And this one was like sparkle diva, like craziness. It was nuts how much sparkle was going on. So actually, kind of like taming this down with some of the white base is actually going to be a really good thing. It's going to make it more wearable. Because the sparkle on this was just like literally out of control. It was out of control. It was like putting gold glitter on my eyes. And I'm sure there are people out there that would love that. I am not one of those that would wear gold glitter on my eyes. I would look like a clown for sure with my curly red hair. Bozo the clown to be exact. Okay, so this is mixing in really nice. Looks really good. Just gonna make sure. It needs more alcohol. And more powder. So I'm not really sure why it does work sometimes to just do straight mica with the press it binder and the alcohol, and why sometimes it doesn't. I did think about just going back in with some more press it binder, more alcohol, and re-wetting it and repressing it. I'm hoping that this is a more complete fix of the issue. We will see though, you know? And obviously I never want to give anyone bad information, but just remember that what I said about the makeup and the micas, you know, the makeup and the eyeshadows and whatnot, I am learning. This is not me saying I know everything and I'm teaching you guys how to do it. This is me saying, hey, this is my first time trying it. Go ahead and like come along with me for the ride. So I apologize if anyone, you know, did this and it didn't work out and it was all because of me, but I'm trying to learn, and I will, the thing that I'm trying to do and the way that I'm trying to be helpful is that basically I'm trying these things, but I'm showing you all of my, you know, all of my successes as well as my disappointments and, you know, my not so successful ventures. So this one's looking pretty good. I'm almost done with this one, I think. I think I'll put just a bit more powder in here, and then I'll call this one good. And what I'm gonna do is, just like I did in my previous video, I hope you guys can see this. I'm trying to stay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead, and once I finish this one, I'm going to turn the camera off. I'm going to go ahead and do the exact same thing to everything else with the other mixes, and then I'll bring you back once I'll press them on camera, and then we'll let them dry out for a day or two, and then we'll come back and we'll see how they're doing, if they've stayed pressed and if they have the consistency that they should and aren't crumbly, powdery, anything like that. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and call that one good. There we go. That's nice. So that's that one. Very pretty. And like I said, I'll bring you guys back when I'm ready to press them all. Okay, I wanted to just tell you guys one thing. So for the press it base, you are supposed to use half a teaspoon of your color to 2 scoops, which it doesn't specify, but to me it looks like they would be either the smidgen or the drop. It's said the small scoop, so maybe it's the drop. So basically, I have about a half teaspoon of color right here, and I'm going to put two drops. So this drop scooper of the Press It base into my baggie with my half teaspoon of color, mica. And then I'm going through this one with you because it's a little bit different. Okay, so two scoops of that. And what you want to do is you want to really mix that around good in your baggie. And what I do is I kind of like flick it, but then I also rub it together to make sure everything's mixed together really good. And then this is the part that's different than I've seen anybody tell you to do. I've never seen a video that tells you to do this, but this is what TKB tells you to do. So it says to open up your baggie, get your Press It binder, and add 5 drops. Okay. And then you're to mix it all up. You can see it's kind of sticking to the sides of the bag, but I'm just going to follow these directions. And I'm going to see how it goes. All right. Just kind of flicking all the extra powder down. And then I've got my pan here. And it says to put alcohol and 1 drop of the Press It binder in the pan. Now we're going to go ahead and scoop. Our mixture into here. I'm going to put some more alcohol. I'm going to add some more alcohol, and then I'm going to add some more powder. That might have been a little much, but it's okay because I gotta put more powder in there anyways. So this consistency is a lot different than the rest of them. It's a lot clumpier. And that may be a good thing, I don't know. Alright, I'm going to put some more of the powder in there. Dang it. That one little drop didn't even go in the pan. Uh-oh, now we're really full. Okay. I'm really curious to see how all of these different eyeshadows come out and which one is the best. Maybe they'll all be good. That's what I'm hoping anyways.
It's 8 o'clock.
All right, so as you can see, that's nice and it's like nice and wet and not too wet though. And it's all adhering together. So I just want to get the rest of this in here. And then once I get the rest of the eyeshadows done, I'll bring you guys back. Okay, let's go ahead and see if we can press these now. So, let's just review. For the white, I used talc, bismuth oxychloride, and boron nitride. And I used those 5 parts talc, 1 part bismuth, and I used well, that doesn't even make sense. I'm not going to be able, I used about 5 parts talc, or you could, yeah, I used five, well, I used my little, how can I explain this? I'm probably going to have to leave it in the description what my recipes were. That's what I'll do because I can't explain it right now because I used my measuring spoon. So I used like 5 pinches of talc, so on. I used different spoons. So I will leave those, I'll leave the recipes for my bases in the description below. And I'll just tell you what I used. I used the talc, bismuth oxychloride, and boron nitride for the white. And then for the gold, I used the same thing. No, I used the My Mix Press It Binder and Base. That's the one that I did the TKB recipe, basically, with half a teaspoon of mica, two small scoops of the My Mix Base, 5 drops of My Mix Press It Binder in the bag, all mixed up, and then 1 drop of My Mix Binder in the pan with alcohol, and then mixed it all in. For the other two, I used the same. I use talc, zinc oxide, and bismuth oxychloride. And basically, I used those at, I used just a small amount of the base, a smaller amount of the base in those than I did on these. So we'll see how that works out. I've got my pressing tile and some of my son's old t-shirt. And I'm just gonna go ahead and press this baby out. I gotta move it out of the camera lens range for just a second so I can get it nearer to me. And I'm really gonna press this one like good and hard. That's another thing that I wondered about when I had that lifting and kind of bubbling up on some of them. I wondered if it was because I did not press them hard enough. You do need to press it pretty hard. You want to put a lot of weight on there. Especially if you're not going to do the layers, like I believe you're kind of... I think that the best way to do it is maybe to do it with the layers. But see, I've heard different thoughts about that. I've heard people say they never do it and everything is fine. But I think that always the directions are to do it in layers. If you're looking at actual instructions on like one of the makeup websites. All right, I am like really trying to get the sides of this down good, because that's where I'm having a little bit, it seems like, an issue getting all that nice and pressed down is on the sides. Let's see. That's what it looks like so far. It looks really pretty. And I'm hoping that this one will be more wearable also. So the fact that I had to redo these, you know, it may not be a bad thing. I may get better result than I did the first time anyways. All right, there we go. I think I've pressed that baby down pretty good. Okay, there's my end result. There's my pan. Isn't that pretty? Okay, And then let's see how this one presses. The one that's the TKB press it binder base with the liquid binder. Kind of wonder if this will be the best one, or if, you know, how big of a difference it'll make whether you use the pre-made base as opposed to my own base that I just formulated by myself. Not by myself, I mean I used, I shouldn't say that, that's not true. I used guidelines, TKB guidelines of what I should use as the base. But it's one that I made out of separate products. That's how I should say it. So I'm pressing this one. It's looking pretty good. That's what it looks like so far. I'm pressing really hard. It seems to be pressing nicely. I'm getting all the excess. You can see that my, I don't know if you can or not, but it's kind of wet. So all that excess alcohol is coming out, which is exactly what I want. And I'm just making sure I get all of the sides really well pressed, because like I said before, that is where it seems like it's a little more difficult to get a really, really good press, is on those sides. And I even had a little bit trying to like spill out of the lip. Let me show you what I'm talking about. See how that side area, you can see there's like a lip there. So I'm trying to make sure I press that down really, really good. I think that looks pretty good. All right, so there's the end result on that one. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to press the rest of these. You guys know what it looks like, you know how it goes, and then I'll bring you back tomorrow and we'll test out how these how the different bases did, and if they stay nice and pressed, or if they start to big crumbly or powdery, and I'll let you know. Thanks for watching. Hey everybody, I'm back to just show you the results of the eyeshadows that I repressed. Let's see, I guess that's the best way to do it. So these are the shadows that I repressed, and I don't know if you can tell, but the finish on them is far better, far smoother, and I don't have any powdering and crumbling. That's a hard, that one, it's hard to tell. See that one? That one's not crumbling up and getting all powdery. It's just a nice, even color there. Same with this one here. These were two that had really, really, they had like bubbled up, and they were all not crumbly, but they were very powdery. When I put my brush on them, they just like powdered all over, and there was a whole bunch of dust everywhere. So it really does make a big difference to do the base and then press them after that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back and I think I may just do it to all of them, because the other thing is I think the finish on these is better. Before they were very, very intense. So intense, which in some ways is great. If you want like a really, really saturated, intense color, it would be great. But I would definitely suggest if you're going to go that route that you, well, first of all, I'd say just do it loose. But the other thing I'd say is definitely use like an eyeshadow primer so that when you put it on, it doesn't just end. And also put protection underneath the eye because you're going to get a lot of extra color falling and dusting everywhere. So I think that this is going to adhere better. It's not going to get all over the place. And like I said, I feel like the finish is a little bit better. It muted it out a tiny bit so that it's not so intense. So, you know, I'm not an expert on this, and I'm always open for suggestions. I'm just trying to like learn along the way, but I always want to give you guys, you know, good and correct information. And if I make a mistake, I want to correct it and help you guys figure out the correct way to do something. So I would definitely use one of the bases I told you about, either TKB's pre-made base or make one of your own, which that's what I did with several of these. And it was very simple. It was simple products and, you know, relatively inexpensive and easy. So there we go. Look at that gold. Isn't that pretty? So all of these colors are super pretty. They're very intense while not being too intense. And they feel really nice. They're very, very smooth, silky, and powdery. All right, guys. This white's still my favorite. I love that one. My hands are really dry right now. Look at how it's hard to see in this light, too. But the colors are still really intense. There you go. All right, guys. Thank you for watching. I hope this helped. I hope this answered some questions also. I had a couple of questions from another subscriber that was having some crumbling. I think it was just crumbling. But anyways, if you have any questions, go ahead and give them to me. If you haven't subscribed, do that. And I will be coming back soon. I'm going to do some really fun, more like light colors for spring, summer. Just these are more like our, I know there's a couple of different colors in there, but these are mainly just your basic, I don't want to say nudes because they're definitely not nudes, but they're more in the natural category, earth tone, whatever you want to call it. So in when I come back, I'm going to do some fun stuff, maybe a couple of glitters even. I haven't done any glitters because I know I'll never wear them, but I did have a subscriber ask me about it. And I have been really kind of curious and I would like to do some glitters. I just know that I won't wear them, and I don't even think my daughters really would because they don't really wear that kind of stuff. But maybe if I made some, maybe they would. So anyways, I'll see you guys on the next video. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Bye-bye.